The Russian Aerospace Forces have officially fielded the R-77M active radar-guided air-to-air missile, as confirmed by a newly released photo showing a Su-35S fighter armed with two of the advanced weapons. This marks the first visual proof of the missile's operational deployment. The R-77M's arrival has been over a decade in the making, and its absence has long been seen as a weakness in Russia's air combat arsenal. Until now, Russian fighters have relied on the older R-77-1, which left them lagging behind US, Chinese, and even European air forces in long-range engagement capability. The new missile is considered a direct counterpart to the Chinese PL-15 and the American AIM-120D European Meteor, with an engagement range of approximately 100 miles, 160 kilometers. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Russia is aiming to bridge the air-to-air capability gap with R-77M. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The R-77M's delayed entry, coming roughly a decade after similar missiles fielded by other major powers, stems largely from the Russian Defense Ministry's limited post-Cold War investment in tactical combat aviation. To place the R-77M's capabilities in perspective, the older R-77-1 had an engagement range of only 68 miles, 110 kilometers, making it broadly equivalent to the American AIM-120C5 and Chinese PL-12. That missile only entered service around 2014, already a generation behind the most advanced foreign systems. The original R-77 stood out for its use of an active radar seeker and distinctive lattice control fins, its most iconic design element. The absence of modern air-to-air missiles had put even Russia's top-tier fighters, like the Su-35S, at a clear disadvantage, both in combat performance and export appeal. This shortfall was widely seen as a key reason why Russia struggled to compete in the global fighter market. The introduction of the R-77M is expected to close much of that gap, bringing Russian air power closer to parity with its Western and Chinese rivals. Viewers may note that in today's air combat environment, beyond visual range, BVR capability is not optional. It's essential. A fighter's survival increasingly depends on its ability to detect, track, and fire at threats before being targeted itself. Missiles like the AIM-120 AMRAAM and MBDA Meteor have set the benchmark in this space, and the R-77M is Russia's answer. In BVR combat, the side that shoots first, accurately, usually wins. That makes long-range missile capability not just an edge, but a necessity. Development of the R-77M began in the 2010. Unlike earlier variants, the R-77M features conventional cropped cruciform tail fins and shorter control surfaces, design changes made to ensure compatibility with the internal weapons bays of the Su-57 stealth fighter and other future low-observable Russian aircraft. These aerodynamic refinements not only enable internal carriage, but also reduce drag and lower the missile's radar cross-section. The R-77M is also believed to be equipped with an active electronically scanned array radar seeker, providing improved resistance to jamming and allowing it to lock onto targets at greater distances. This marks a significant leap in guidance technology over previous models. The R-77M features a new dual-pulse solid-fuel rocket motor, providing two distinct thrust phases, an initial burn for mid-course flight, followed by a delayed second pulse for high-speed terminal maneuvering. This setup not only extends the missile's effective range, but also enhances its agility during intercepts. It's believed the R-77M can execute maneuvers up to 27 G, making it highly capable against evasive targets. Though its development was plagued by significant delays, the missile's deployment appears to have been fast-tracked due to active combat operations in Ukraine and rising tensions with NATO across Eastern Europe, the Arctic, and the Pacific. The entry of the R-77M into service is a critical step to keep Russian fighter units relevant, especially as NATO expands its fleets of stealth aircraft and sharpens its edge in long-range air combat. The R-77M is expected to significantly boost the combat effectiveness of key Russian platforms, like the Su-35S and Su-30SM, which make up the core of the country's fighter fleet. Su-57 will also benefit. Its deployment could help close the gap with Western and allied air forces, while also strengthening Russia's existing advantage in the Ukrainian theater. Douglas Berry, Senior Fellow for Military Aerospace at the International Institute for Strategic Studies, has noted the strong likelihood that the R-77M will see combat testing in Ukraine. He emphasized that the missile should offer a notable increase in range, seeker performance, and countermeasures resistance compared to earlier Russian air-to-air missile systems. Ukrainian defense analysts have warned that the R-77M poses a serious challenge to aircraft like the MiG-29 and F-16AM, making Ukrainian air operations more dangerous and further increasing the risk of long-range engagements in contested airspace. With its extended range, improved seeker, and greater resistance to countermeasures, the missile isn't just a standoff deterrent, it's capable of engaging even modern stealth and electronic warfare-equipped fighters. Combined with the Russian Aerospace Forces' current tactics, particularly their use of high-altitude patrols, the presence of a missile like the R-77M significantly raises the threat level for any aircraft operating within reach. Until now, the primary concern was the R-37, which offers extended range of 250 miles, 400 kilometers, and is mostly deployed by MiG-31, but deemed to be suitable for taking out primarily large aircraft like AWACS and aerial refuelers. Now, the R-77M presents a new threat vector. With Russia ramping up production of its main fighter platforms, the Su-34, Su-35, and Su-57, demand for the R-77M is likely to far exceed that of earlier R-77 variants. Given the heightened security challenges, the Russian Defense Ministry is expected to fund large-scale procurement to equip frontline units. There is a strong possibility the R-77M could fully replace older models in production, becoming the standard air-to-air missile across its combat aviation forces.